Red Wings Live on Fox Sports Detroit is presented by Arby's. Well, TGIF, thank you for kicking off your weekend with Red Wings Live, along with Darren Elliott and Chris Osgood. I'm Mickey York. The Wings and Islanders get together here at the bottom of the hour in what should be an entertaining hockey game. Entertainment is not the first word that comes to mind when hearkening back to Tuesday's game with the Blue Jackets. Folks have been grumbling about the shootout ever since, but the game did mark the return of Justin Abdelkader and Danny DeKeyser, and I know you both liked what you saw from those players in that game.
Yeah, most certainly did. Abdelkader's a heavy player. He played very well last game for being out for a little while there, but he was skating well, going to the net like he always does. And the Red Wings need this guy in the lineup. He's a gritty player. He does the little things for the Red Wings. Here he had an opportunity, taking a huge hit, winning him a bit there. He felt that a lot, but he got back up and continued to play a good game for the Wings.
Danny DeKeyser out for a couple of games. He comes back into the mix. Leads everyone in time on ice, 23 minutes and 23 seconds, jumping up into the play. Handcuffed with that pass, but not out of the play at all. Watch him get all the way back, make a fantastic play at the top of the crease. Most impressive, A, the skating to get back, and B, doesn't take a penalty. Fantastic play by Danny DeKeyser.
And both those guys played well, but, of course, in a losing effort against the Blue Jackets on Tuesday night. It would also be nice to see the Wings score a goal at some point in regulation tonight. It's been a while, but the offense is expected to get a little more firepower back this evening. For more on that, we head downtown where John Keating has assumed his perch above the Joe Louis Concourse. Good evening, John.
Good evening, Mick. Happy Friday to everybody out there. Welcome downtown. So I'm flipping channels, as we all often do, but never during Red Wings Live. And I see a show listed as Hand to God, Have a Turkey Neck, which, as it turns out, has nothing to do with turkeys. But there are questions which really have no answers, such as, can Johan Franzen be Johan Franzen again? Perhaps after a little bit of a break. The Mule didn't play on Tuesday, as it was revealed he was battling a bug that just wouldn't go away. Not the mumps, but enough of the flu or something to leave him weakened. He's back in there tonight, hoping to have more energy and success. He last scored a goal November 20th.
Yeah, it's tough to play a game out there when you don't have, when we have zero energy. But I was battling different stuff for the last few weeks, and finally, like, this Sunday, the body is shut down pretty much. So just, you know, try to get some days off and try to get healthy.
How much did that help you?
We'll see tonight, but you know, I feel a lot better. You know, it's good to be skating again. I was off for 5 days, I think. So, but still, like, when you miss 5 days of skating, it's going to be tough coming back because you lose it pretty quick. But, like, health-wise, I feel a lot better.
But you know how Franzen has that track record of going off. If he or any of the Red Wings has a hat trick tonight, you can bring a copy of the scoring summary to any Arby's tomorrow for a free small order of curly fries. For the last few years, the best player on the Islanders has been sort of, well, living on an island. John Tavares hasn't been, or hasn't had much help around him since he was picked first overall by New York back in 2009. But after an injury last year, he is back and then some. With more on the star who makes the aisles go, downstairs we go. There is the lovely Trevor Thompson. T, good evening.
Hey, Keats, you know John Tavares is a kid who's always been a bit ahead of his time. As a 14-year-old, he was the youngest player ever to be drafted in the Ontario Hockey League. In 2007, he petitioned the AHL to play in that league as an underage player. And then in 2008, he petitioned the NHL to be draft eligible a year early. Both of those petitions were shot down. But as you mentioned, in 2009, he became the number one pick in the draft, was drafted by the Islanders, and has only seen his game grow ever since. Earlier today, I had a chance to ask the Islanders captain where he thinks he's at on his NHL learning curve at this point in his life.
I think everything. You know, I always wanted to be an all-around player, can be counted on in any situations, and have the trust of the coaching staff and the team in that way, and continue to get better offensively, continue to be more consistent producing, and you know, I always feel like I can be a lot better at scoring. It's something I've always been known for growing up, and certainly I've always wanted to be a dual threat and be a tough guy to read, but I certainly think I can capitalize on my chances more.
What about being a captain and a leader at this stage of your career? What does that mean to you?
Well, it's a big honor to be a captain in the NHL, especially only 24, and I got such a great group of guys and for a great organization and with great fans and tremendous support. It certainly is honoring, very humbling, and you know, you don't take something like that lightly.
And the Islanders captain was also a member of the Canadian Olympic team, coached by Mike Babcock in Sochi last year. Had to leave the tournament early with a knee injury, did not play the rest of the season in the NHL, but has bounced back to true form so far this year as he continues to lead the Isles, one of the surprise teams in the East. You'll get an up-close look at he and the rest of his team here tonight as they try to extend the Red Wings winless streak to 5. We'll see how they make out with that as this one rolls on in the Joe tonight. John, back up to you for now.
All right, Trev, thanks. Right back to Trevor Thompson a little bit later in Red Wings Live. They weren't exactly the Edmonton Oilers, but remember, there was that stretch where the Wings offense was rolling suntans from goal lights, yet now there are skid marks. And we'll talk of finding more nets as we continue this Friday night. Red Wings Live on Fox Sports Detroit is brought to you by your local Toyota dealers. Visit buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places. And by Motor City Casino Hotel, a million miles away, right down the street. The Red Wings' not-so-secret weapon tonight may be drooling Darren Helm because he has uncommon success against the Isles. One goal last November, had some thrill ride attached to it. Keep your hands and feet inside the car, up and over on a breakaway. A shorthanded goal against goalie Kevin Poulin, one that everybody will remember for a while.
I've seen it a few times, not as many as you'd think. There's a lot of pitchers floating around with me just laying on my back behind the goal line with the puck in the net, so it's pretty memorable goal for myself.
Helmer has 3 multi-point games against the Islanders. He was actually surprised to learn that today. He was also surprised to learn this. In games in which he has a point this season, the Wings are 10-2-1. So look for Darren Helm to get involved offensively tonight. Darren and Ozzie rejoin us now from the studio for the Miller Lite Breakdown. Guys, in their last 282 minutes of regulation time, the Wings have scored exactly 1 goal. That has to change tonight, but they're getting plenty of shots, Darren.
Yeah, but they're coming from the outside, Keith. That's one of the things. I'll trust your math on the goals and the minutes, but what they have to do is get the puck to the inside. Last game, unable to do so. They were able to get the puck into the zone, spend some time there, but never where they needed to. We saw the last segment. Justin Albuquerque had a good shot from the middle of the ice. That didn't happen very often. This happened far too often. Puck goes down, puck retrieval, kind of, sort of. No, easy exit for the Blue Jackets. It was like that most of the night.
Yeah, they have to find a way to get back to the inside, and that entails driving to there with a puck, not being satisfied to stay on the outside like Nicholas Cromwell does right here. The Columbus Blue Jackets have a big defense. Islanders are getting 2 big pieces back on defense tonight. The Red Wings are going to have to get to the house, and that's in front of the goalie, get pucks there and get bodies there. We haven't seen much of that middle lane drive of late like we saw earlier in the year when they're really scoring some goals. They got to get back to that, try and get some ugly goals, get pucks to the net and bodies to the net.
Maybe, just maybe, the chance to get going offensively will come when the Wings have the extra man. Detroit's 7th best on the power play. Meanwhile, the Islanders dead last, 30th on the penalty kill, Oz.
When your penalty kill is 71%, that's nothing but atrocious. That's not very good at all. The Red Wings' power play has been very good. Even when they weren't scoring, they're still generating opportunity. This thing has been a weapon all season long for the Red Wings. It's been great. First 8 games, not very good at all. Next 18, sizzling at 29%. Then it kind of gets where you would expect, Darren, at 17.6%. But this has been really good all year long besides the first 8 games.
And you can carve the numbers up on special teams any way you want. The overall, the totals are really what's relevant because the 3-for-17 is really 3 for their last 7. Oh, yeah, that means they were 0-for-10 before that. They have to really take advantage of the power play. I think it's the catalyst for their offense. Feel good about yourself in the power play, it'll translate and carry over to 5-on-5 play.
All right, right back to you guys shortly. They're spending their last season in God's gift to hockey, Nassau County Coliseum on Long Island. Off to Brooklyn next for the Islanders. Darren and Ozzie will talk of a team building something as they transition. Next.
It's time for tonight's Metro Detroit Chevy Dealers Chevy in the D feature. Go to FoxSportsDetroit.com and check out the post-game Grub in the D story, highlighting the top places to eat after a Wings game, such as Hockey Town Cafe, Bucharest Grill, and Kobo Joe's, to name just a few. Of course, the
Hope is that your postgame grub comes in celebration of a Red Wings victory tonight, but of course that's easier said than done against a vastly improved Islanders team. And guys, a big part of the Isles' success this season because of the shrewd moves they made this offseason, which we'll highlight in the business of hockey, brought to you by Walsh College, Ozzie.
Yeah, really, general manager Gar Snow, who really didn't make a lot of good deals his first little tender as a GM, but really has been good here in the last while, especially just before the season started in training camp when he picked up Johnny Boychuk and Nick Leddy. What's key for them is they're both Stanley Cup champions. They know how to win, and they bring that attitude in the dressing room with a lot of young players and have taught them how to be a pro on and off the ice. And Kulemin and Grabowski have come over, and they've been great, mirroring each other with 5 goals, 7 assists, both with 12 points. And Halak, obviously, coming over from the Capitals, former St. Louis Blue, has been solid all year, Darren.
Dependable. You just dropped 5 NHL players into your lineup. You've got to be better, and the Islanders have to.
And the new talent has helped. There's no question about that. But a lot of the success can be attributed to their homegrown guys certainly coming of age.
Yeah, it took a long time to grow the talent. But again, to have the depth around them has helped, as we just saw. This has been going on for a long time. The centerpiece to this, as Trevor talked about, John Tavares, the first overall pick in 09. But Oposo himself, 7th overall in 06. Brock Nelson himself, I didn't realize he's a first-round pick. Last pick in the first round. Ryan Strome, he's a first-round pick. As is Brock, and you have Nielsen as well. So you have a lot of guys there that this has been expected for a long time. Now it's coming together.
And I think the key to this whole thing with the success of the Islanders is they've surrounded these young players with dependable veteran players now, with the guys you mentioned beforehand, and now they really have a team that's tough to play against and knows how to win and go into each and every game thinking that they can win.
And Nelson's a guy deadly on the power play. Yeah. 8 of his goals this year have come with a man advantage, right? Islanders new and old, though, had better be aware of Luke Glendening tonight, especially in the face-off circle. But the Michigan alum has been a little distracted this week. Not only is his school coming into the Joe for the GLI, but perhaps you've heard about this Jim Harbaugh fella. We'll find out if the hysteria has permeated the Wings dressing room next.
Brought to you by ZotAuto.com, home of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, Ram, Ford, Toyota, and Scion. And by Flagstar Bank, a proud and official partner of the Detroit Red Wings. Wings and Islanders upcoming. Lots of them landed really good jobs, and success is always the best revenge. But you know this. It's been a little tough to be a University of Michigan alum because there has been so much focus on a football coaching vacancy that is still, you know, vacant. Former Michigan hockey captain Luke Glendening, among those on Jim Harbaugh watch.
A little bit. Not getting too into it, but obviously I saw the deal he was offered or proposed, and hopefully he'll take it.
Are you surprised it's taken as long as it's taken to figure out who's going to be the next coach?
Yeah, you think it would be a job that people want, but I guess in the recent struggles, it's probably a lot of heat on that seat, so we'll see what happens.
Michigan, Michigan State, Michigan Tech, and Ferris State in the Great Lakes Invitational on Fox Sports Detroit December 28th and 29th here at the Joe. The Wings are not playing badly. They're just not playing well enough to win lately, and that's an important distinction. 0-1-3 in their last four. How much concern for the captain? Henrik Zetterberg downstairs with Trevor Thompson. T.
John, thank you very much. Henrik, when you look at the standings, everybody would be pleased where you're at right now, but this little road bump aside, how do you feel about the way the team's playing at this point in the season?
Well, I think we're doing a lot of good things, but in the same thing, we can improve on a lot of stuff. You know, we haven't played the way we want here at home lately, and we just got to fix that tonight.
You're going to face another one of the surprise teams in the East and the New York Islanders over here tonight. What's made them so tough, and what's the game plan against them here tonight?
Well, they have, overall good team. Got good forwards, skilled forwards. Made some good acquisitions in the summertime for some defense, and the goalie's playing well. So it's going to be a tough task for us here, but it's going to be a challenge.
Henrik, thanks for this, and good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Here goes Henrik Zetterberg. He and the Wings trying to snap a 4-game winless streak here against the Isles tonight, John.
All right, Trev, thanks. It's true for CBS and for the Wings. You're familiar with watching whatever happens after 60 minutes through your fingers. Scared to death. We'll talk of the dramatically different results in OT after this. Here in Detroit, Detroit, we can't fathom it. The reaction is gone. But the Islanders look at regulation as, you know, the pregame skate. They're an idiotically good 9-0 in games that went to overtime or a shootout. Kyle Okposo 5-for-6 in the one-on-one goalie battles. Franz Nielsen is 4-for-6. And that hockey shootout is Miley Cyrus. It was cute for a while. Now it's just a little bit scary. The Red Wings' record on the other side of regulation, it's not ideal, at least not yet, and it is downright ugly. 2-2 in overtime, 1-6 in shootouts, two vastly different mindsets. If, heaven forbid, we find ourselves playing beyond a third period tonight.
Obviously, I'm surprised because we have lots of talent, really skilled guys in the locker room. Just the way how it is, you know, when there's nothing. We don't want to play in overtime or in a shootout. We want to win a regular time, and for some reason we can find a way, you know, shootouts.
We got a lot of skill in here and a lot of confidence that we can get it done in those shootouts. You know, Yaro has been good too. Some big saves, you know, we know if we can score one, we got a chance.
Let's win in the 4-on-4. So last game I had 3 forwards out there, Wendy. I'm going to do it again if we get to that point. I'd rather win 5-on-5 in regulation and get the job done. And then if we go to the shootout, let's all be strong mentally. Let's flush what's happened in the past. It's a new day. The sun got up. And let's be the best we can be.
We would say this even if the results were shinier. It's a lousy way to end a hockey game, but it's not going away anytime soon, so the Wings realize you just have to find a way, and as they get set to take on this vastly improved Islanders team, they're aware that each team with different endings has the same 42 points. Back to the studio now. Back to Mickey, Darren, and Ozzie. Gentlemen.
All right, John, thank you. And to your point, John, yeah, if you root for anything tonight, root for 60 minutes of hockey, for Pete's sake, and root for someone in red to score a goal. Darren and Ozzie, as you take your one-timers, who might be a couple of likely candidates for the Wings tonight?
Well, a healthier and better feeling, Johan Franz and the Mule will be back in the lineup tonight, and goals have been not a lot of late, and they'll need this guy to start shooting more and get into the net with that big body. Wasn't skating as well as he could when he was feeling a little bit under the weather. But obviously him back in the lineup, he looks re-energized. Looks like he's ready to go tonight. And Nyquist, too, has gotten a little cold of late. They're going to need him to start driving there. We talked about the Wings being on the inside and on the outside. This guy was fabulous for the first 20 games of the season. They're going to need him to get hot again, maybe on the power play with a couple opportunities there to sting this Islanders penalty kill.
Talk about power play. You had 2 blue-chip defensemen. Nick Leddy goes on the blue line. He quarterbacks 1 power play unit. He's playing great hockey on the back end for the Islanders, and his defense partner acquired the same way. Nick Boychuk missed 9 games. He's back in the lineup. He's the quarterback of the other power play unit, and they play together at even strength. They are the reason the Islanders have been so good.
Wings and Isles coming away next. Kenna Mick with the call. We'll see you back here during the intermissions and again after the game for Red Wings Live.